let it sink. What's your purpose? What's your passion?
Through the pain, what's your plan?
Is it plain? On a plane? Hydroplane? I'm just playing.
What's your purpose? What's your passion?
Did it pay?
What's your plan? Is it plain? On a plane? Hydroplane? I'm just playing.
I mean, it's something about a fresh line. Make a man feel like a million bucks. Fresh fade, get the tape or the shadow on it. Them waves so deep, you need a paddle for them. I mean, it's more than just hair. It's the confidence you feeling when you step up out that chair. And I swear, they tell me every bob is mean. From Trav Herm, B to Sayyid, now say hello to the team. Cause the style's supreme, my nigga, don't forget the style supreme. They know the style supreme, supreme style. Keep the whole town clean, get a can of that sheen. Spray it on me, make me feel like a king.
Like a king.
That's what I mean by gold dreams. And they gon' get up on this smooth shit one day, one day, one day, one day. And you can...
In my day, the barber was a counselor. He was a fashion expert. He was a style coach, pimp. Just general all-around hustler.
I said all them things a long time ago, but I say this here, I'm still pretty.
Peace, Abarigani, Hotep, what's happening? Assalamu alaikum and Ramadan Mubarak to all of my Muslim and fasting brothers and sisters. You're watching hashtag supremely faded, the real barbershop podcast, and let me see if we can bring them on in.
Grand Rising Kings.
Grand Rising.
Grand Rising Queens. And it's Grand Rising Niggas.
The Supreme Style Barber. Here we go. Supreme Style Barbers are in the building. Kind of, sort of. Trav and Sayyid's here.
Hey, hey. Kind of, sort of here. Sayyid.
Almost finished.
Hey, Mrs. Adams. Hey, Big Bruce.
Tweet.
Phone's ringing. We don't normally answer the phone at Supreme Styles.
We never answer the phone. Y'all start calling that fucking phone.
I don't even know why we got a phone. Why do we have a phone in the first place?
Sometimes we answer it.
Don't nobody got a house phone no more.
Unless they got somebody on parole over there. Like...
They're going to call back. Man, I've been calling y'all.
Been trying to get an appointment. let's see, hold on. Okay, so how was you guys weekend?
My weekend was fly.
It was dope.
I swear I had a fly ass weekend.
What you do, sir?
I was outside. Friday night, went to the trio, Tanya's birthday. Happy birthday, Tanya Davis.
Oh, you was getting it in. Happy birthday, Miss Tanya.
Tanya Cooper Davis. Saturday night, I went to your mama's house. I think that's what it is. It's a club downtown. Trev performed.
Your mama's house.
That's and then cool. I was going to go to the grand opening of the foreplay. But it was too late. And then Sunday night, I went to the Scarface concert. Sunday I went to church and saw, I went to the House of Joy. I saw the C2 Mass Choir get down.
Snap. Trav went to church.
And then I left there and went to the Scarface concert.
must have been Easter.
Went to church and into the Scarface concert.
That's my DNA makeup, man. You know what I'm saying?
That's called bounce.
It's bounce, man. And the Scarface concert was dope. Dude had a live band behind him, y'all.
Mrs. Charles is in the building. She says she still has a house phone. Why y'all hating? Hey, Travis, your wife said y'all got a house phone too.
We do. We do. And I let it ring like this for here.
Oh, man. Miss Yolanda's in the building. Hey, Yolanda. What you do, Sayyid?
I didn't do nothing. I didn't do nothing. Debated with some people online about Easter. Which, you know,
oh my God!
But that's about it. Nothing really.
Of course, I went to the mosque. I did the lecture, and we touched on Easter. We ripped the head off of the Easter bunny on Sunday.
Did you?
Gotta rip the head off the Easter bunny.
Just briefly though, we didn't. Yeah, we went in a little bit.
Yeah,
I have to post it. Tiara's in the building. Hey, Miss Tiara. But it was a good time, man. We're freestyling. What I noticed about Easter, y'all. First, I noticed it, of course, at the barbershop, and it's been like the last couple of, well, actually, few years, even before the pandemic. Easter used to be like one of the biggest weekends at the barbershop, but now you don't see it so much. People don't, you know what I'm saying? I mean, we still busy, but it ain't like, people not trying to get in like that.
I know when we first became barbers, the Saturday before Easter was an all day
right,
man. Yes. We was here from 7-8 to like 7. Cutting a ton of little boys, everybody getting their hair cut, you know.
Right. So what do you all attribute that to? The decline. Cuz Thanksgiving is popping, of course. Christmas is always popping. New Year's.
I think people are starting to learn about the origins of Easter and, you know, looking at some of the pagan rituals that are laced in religion. Even the church itself is not really calling it Easter anymore. They're calling it
Resurrection Sunday.
So I think even the church is starting to explore some of the origins of it, you know.
Mike Goodlow's in the building. Hollywood Barber's in the house.
Yeah, Mike. That's what I'm talking about. Mike?
Hey, good Mike. How was y'all's Easter weekend? And Sister Sherelle said, "Don't nobody go to church no more."
That's part of it. That's part of it. Yeah. You know, since church is online, so I think that the decline where people can actually lie and say, "Well, I went online this morning."
You can cash up your tithes.
You can zero your tithes. I don't know about tithes.
You don't know about tithing?
The tithing part. Like, I know about sowing into something, but the whole tithing thing, people starting to see, like, I think this era, it's kind of woke. You know, I say kind of, but not really woke, but
people want to see where they tell you where money's going.
Well, if you've been at a church for 40 years and the building fund and they ain't changed the bathroom of that motherfucker, they ain't put a new sink in or nothing. The same pop machine been in the church the whole time.
With
the old one that you can stick your hand up in and put a pop in.
Yeah, with the paper sign, cola written in ink. You don't know what color you're gonna get. You might get Pepsi, you might get Coke.
Yeah, so I think everybody's like starting to see, like, you know, when the preachers pop out,
right,
and they got the lamp, you know, they in the Hummers and they in the nice nice cars, the Cadillacs, you know, they always been like that. But now they're starting to see, like, people's kind of struggling. And I'm giving my money, and this dude is like, you know.
Kind of bald.
And then, like, say, like, when Joel Osteen didn't open that church during that hurricane.
Katrina.
Right.
Come on, man. That's, people start to see that, like, okay, so. Mm-hmm. And then people not getting buried properly. Right. Like, sometimes the church charge you to bury you. To have your service there.
Right.
And I don't pay tithes to this month for 30, 40 years.
Church
years.
Is big business.
Church, you know, I spoke business. To a brother on Saturday, and he said, yeah, we burying my grandmother in August. And I'm like, August? He's from Africa. So it's like everybody from over there want to come to the funeral. And I'm like, I did not know that you could hold a body that
yeah,
long.
You can.
You can hold a body as long as you want.
Yeah, you can.
You remember when James Brown died? They held him for like a year or something like that.
Before they buried him?
Yeah.
I did not know that.
Yes.
Dang. But, you know, but people, but you're right though, Chad. People want to see where their money going, man. And if they don't see it going nowhere, then they like, okay, I feel like I'm getting hustled right here. Don't nobody want to feel like they're getting hustled.
Well, that's even the older people. The older people, they stop going too. So. You can't say it's just the kids or the mid-range adults. Like,
so how
the older people, the elders are not going to church either. Right.
So how was the numbers in the church that you went to on Sunday? Was it packed? Or was
it was a musical, so it was cracking.
Oh, okay.
It was a musical.
It was a musical. It was a special type.
Yeah, they still had an offering. And the offering part was still kind of, you know, like, okay, so now they're really like, doing the microscopic offering, like,
right.
If you're giving $40 and above, stand up.
Right.
You can't get less than 20. So I'm like, he's like, and we got a Cash App.
Wow.
Go to Cash App, blah, 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 so dollar sign. And I'll
write it. They go get their
All right, all right. You know, but it was a free concert. It was a free concert.
Okay.
So I seen, you know, the, I did, you know, my sister's in the choir, so Kim Moore, big ups, Kim.
Big Mike, Crazy Mike said, people are into bedside churches now.
Yeah.
Bedside. So they be getting up, watching the webcast and they draws, eating their cornflakes. Praise the Lord.
What is more comfortable than that? You done made you some pancakes. You sit in the living room with your flat screen. And
hold on, man. If I go to work like that, you think I'm going to go to church like that? I go to work like that. Oh.
Take this.
Ten. Microphone. Oh.
So now you with that kind of attitude, that's why you see so many people in their pajamas in grocery stores. You know.
Oh man, I hate that.
Make sure
you people.
I hate
people
that.
People are so used to the not getting dressed up for nothing anymore.
You know, you can lose a fight easy, like in your pajamas, because you know you're not dressed for the fight.
You're not dressed for the fight.
That's like fighting somebody naked. Like I can't really fight this nigga naked. You know what I'm saying? So I get my ass whipped.
I saw a sister in the grocery store in some. These look like some funky ass pajama pants. She had a shirt. She had a belly with the belly was hanging out the bottom of the shirt. She had a what's the little things on the head that the sister be rocking?
Yeah,
all the
little
time.
Bonnet.
Little bonnet, man. And I was with my daughter Nasira, and I said, "You see that lady right there?" I said, this is what you don't do ever. Ever in
I'm
life.
Old school. I'm like Trav. I don't wear open toe shoes out the house.
No, I don't want no sandals. I'm not wearing them sandals. No. I'm not wearing nothing.
You
like that shit.
Somebody
I don't know who's gonna run up on me, man. Right. I'm not about to.
I'm not wearing no Crocs. Who wears Crocs? You can't find
all
the shoes Crocs.
Betsy, that's the thing. They got guns. They're like, you know what?
I'm wearing my open toe sandals.
I'm wearing my pajamas.
I guess that is different if you got a gun.
Yeah, see, I'm always thinking fight. You know, leave the house. Don't leave the house like that.
Right. In your pajamas.
You done got up out the bed.
I got some sweet pajamas, too. I be wanting to wear them out. I'm like, man, I be scared. I don't even want to wear them out. I don't even want to wear them out and be in the trash.
But these people be getting about the bed straight to the car, to the grocery store. They still got little pea spots in the bottom of their head.
Why are you this?
They little tinker spots.
Chat room, do y'all wear pajamas out the house? wear house shoes.
That is like the most disgraceful thing, man. Like,
right.
Flip flops.
Some slides. They call them slides.
Slides.
So you know, like back in the day, you could actually fight with the thing between the toes.
Oh, I've seen people get down. Oh,
yes. I've seen karate dudes do that, like with the flip flop.
Right. Yeah.
And the thing is covering your big toe.
Yeah.
You got footing. You could right. actually kick somebody.
Yeah.
And them slides, man, it's over. Either you get whipped out of them or you coming out of them.
With the little flip flops, your toe be gripping that.
Yeah,
little.
Yeah. Bam.
Bam. Feet quick. Flops. Oh, man. Miss Carletta said, no pajamas or bonnets. That's right. Inside your house attire.
Absolutely.
I agree.
Boys with bonnets, though, that's what.
Boys with bonnets, that's like the
I new, don't like that.
That's like the new curl bag.
That's the new curl bag. I used to wear a curl bag, but not outside the house.
Right.
My mom was like, you better not wear that outside this house.
I mean, when I was in high school, niggas used to wear curl bags underneath their football helmets.
Right. For real.
Yeah.
When exactly I mean, curl bag is one thing. When exactly did a do-rag become a fashion accessory?
When rappers started doing
back with us, young high school.
Right.
We were told that we can get waves. And you know what? I think the white man planted do-rags so they could lose their hair up top. Because it smothers your hair while you sleep. Your hair can't breathe. But I be seeing dudes with do-rags all the time. They got bald spots. They're like, oh, man, a do-rag got you.
Got you. I think baseball caps be killing them spots.
Some hairline.
Yeah, baseball caps do too. Like, you wear a hat every day. Like, mm-hmm. See, your hair's.
No,
let's get his hair.
Baseball caps kill this.
No. They kill the top two.
Right here too.
They kill the top two.
Kill them corners.
See, because the hair is like a plant.
Uh-oh.
It's like a plant, and it has to breathe. So if you don't let your hair breathe, sometimes, I could put a bonnet. I could, you know what I mean?
You know, in high school, the girls who ran track hair used to look like that.
Hashim Hakeem is in the building. Slava Legos, Hashim.
What up?
So he says, so the do-rag pulls your hair out?
No. It smothers. I think it smothers your scalp. Because you got that Murray's on there. That Murray's is helping it. That grease is helping it, so you sweep.
No, that Murray's is a hairline killer.
But your hair is really trying to breathe. Right. Your hair can't breathe, so you clogging everything. That's when the decline in
so
your
when
hair.
So when you have like a thick grease like Murray's, that clogs up the hair follicle, and so the hair.
But it's thick when you sleep, and you're trying to sweat that out. You can't sweat it out. It's blocked in, and it's like. Caked up on your head.
I used to wear a do-rag when I had hair, but I would only wear it when I got out of the shower to
get your waves
until my hair dried.
To maintain your waves.
Yep.
Yeah. But there's people that wear it all day outside.
Right. They be matching their outfits.
And sleep in it.
Right.
I used to sleep in my do-rag too.
And sleep with the do-rag on.
Right.
Do-rags be funky.
Wake up do-rag funky smelling like, ooh.
Don't never wash that joint.
Right, don't ever wash it. It's just thick. Hey, you can pull some grease off of it. Put it back.
You get a butter knife on that dude as a time. And then put it on his head.
Yeah.
Oh my God!
Yo, Hashim, your son's album is fire!
Shout outs to the Golden Child.
Woo!
Y'all get the Golden Child's album on iTunes. It's called War Cry.
That thing hit.
Hitting. He got it from his daddy. I see you, Hashim. See you over there.
Yeah.
I see you over there, brother. All praises due to Allah.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's a hot joint. Kadir is really talented. Number one.
Get it from his daddy, man.
Number two, the lyrics are on point, man.
Lyrics is on point.
Straight conscious, and he is straight spitting.
And that's the thing, because he pulled a youth in with them beats.
Right.
But then he lacing it with that.
With that lyrical.
With that lyrical, man. That's like a perfect. That's like Trail. That's like Trail.
That's like Trail.
Yeah. Yeah, I like
that. You know we listening in Denver, brother. We got iTunes out here.
Come on, man. Yeah.
We listening on a mountain, brother.
I see my bought that album, 80 feet high.
And we had every album you had.
Right.
Yeah.
We still got still 100 in the rotation. I was looking at my
We still. We,
and my little
we still
CD
need you to put something out. That's real.
Right. You need to put something out, bro. And I use your sample one on the Final Call News Hour too.
Yep.
So you know y'all in the building.
Come on,
man.
Now.
Come on, Hashim.
It's family, brother.
It's family.
Hey, Brian.
Hey, Brian. B, I got a mic for you.
B is in case
you
want to
join. We talk about any and everything, B. It's freestyle.
Yeah, we talking about
do-rags, man.
Do-rags.
Do-rags losing their hair.
Yeah.
Do y'all got any barber pet peeves that the people need to know about?
Yes. I'm going to let everybody go first.
Yes.
I'm going to let y'all go first.
Please don't come in here asking for a haircut that you know damn well you can't get.
Yeah. You can't get no mohawk if you don't have no hair on your mouth.
Right. you want your hair to look like Usher,
and you got a picture,
and your hair and actually look like Yafet Kodo.
Listen, when you show us the picture, we all look at each other like,
like, so you
come on, know, man.
People be thinking you a musician.
Kino's in the chat room. He wants to snitch on somebody. He keeps wanting to talk about snitching. Kino, who are you trying to snitch on?
Okay, I got one. Okay, I wake up on my way. I take a shower. I brush my teeth. I do that for myself, and I do that for you. So help me out, man. Brush up my fucking teeth, man. You talking to me, man? I don't want to have to turn, man.
That just, part.
You know, like we don't say nothing, but why do you be like, damn, man?
Right.
Help me out, man. It takes 1 minute. A minute and a half to brush their teeth. Mm-hmm.
Sometimes they brush things so bad you can smell it through their ears.
Hey, and wash your ass, man. This teeth is leather, man. These teeth is leather and they get hot. If your ass is hot, we're going to smell it, man.
Oh, my God.
We don't want
to. You say as soon as you get up in that cushion,
oh, my goodness. Oh, my goodness. The Herm got a spray, like, shit.
Oh, my God.
He's wiping it.
Y'all remember that last client I had, man. That fucker, man. He was offensive. He smelled so bad. Like, I was mad. God. Yeah, take a shower, man.
You had to take your cape outside and Febreze it.
I'm not going to say, man. He did. He had a Febreze cape. I'm not going to say, man. I don't know O's client's name. But this dude, he comes in from work. And his job makes him smell like a brothel. Like he works at a fish market.
A brothel.
That made me stinking. I was like, y'all smell that? Smell like some dead fish in here.
Kino said, I be giving haircuts when they're not due. You know what
he's
talking about?
You know what he's talking about.
He's such a hater, Kino.
I told Kino he better stop fucking with him. He got to rip his ass. I knew we were fighting him.
Boxing. Martial arts, man. Leave that
man
alone.
Yeah, leave that man alone.
Leave that man alone. Oh, my God.
You guys, what's your pet peeve, bro?
Man, mine is when you try and line them up and they be talking and moving like this, talking to other people. Like, bro, keep your head straight. and trying to turn the chair while you do it.
Or have your foot on the ground.
Yeah.
Oh my God, I had a foot on the ground. Get your foot off the ground, man.
I just need to keep my head straight. I don't want to break
somebody's ankle. Just like look, see which way it's going, and just turn my chair up real hard that way.
I think I noticed it more so like, you know, like immigrant brothers, when you edge them up, they want to give you, they want to help you with their head and move your head. Keep your head still. You know, they want to like.
Hey, my uncle be doing that shit. I'm like, nigga, you want to do this? Hey, you edge him up, he like this.
Yeah.
All right. If you don't stop moving.
Y'all be making Trev do that. I be trying to do Trev, and y'all be talking to Trev. Like that. And I be like, God damn, nigga.
Or when your client look you dead in the eyes.
Oh my God. You giving a lot of.
What are you looking at?
He looking at you with doughy eyes.
He's like this. Yeah. Yeah, put your head down, man. Look right here. Look right here. Close your eyes, man.
I think one of my pet peeves, I'm gonna circle back on the durag thing. It's like the young men between like I said like 14 and 25.
Right.
That keep the durag on, don't wash their hair. Danger builds up with
all that grease being.
You want something to jump out?
Yeah. Because then you have like sweat, pomade,
dirt,
dry skin, and then it does get to stinking, man. You know that's like a huge
that's terrible.
That's a big
that pet grease build up, or when it gets to get real flaky. Yeah.
No. Or when the customer thinks that putting a fresh thing of pomade on your
right before your haircut,
that's what they're supposed to do.
They're going
to
enhance the haircut.
They're going to lock their ways.
That's a grease trap to us.
Yeah. That's not a good idea. Keep your hair dry when you come in the barbershop.
Exactly. Kino said, my barber plays slots and dogs, so what's the difference?
You still get a haircut, motherfucker. You still get a haircut on time.
And Tiara said, y'all don't like eye contact?
No,
we do not. We do not like eye contact. Close your eyes.
Especially if they're like, you edging them up and they're looking at you, and then you turn around and they're like...
Or this one. This used to be all the African clients. They'd be like, so as you take a little break, they'd be like,
right.
You got to turn around.
Hey, man, did y'all see that Tiara posted a picture of some chicken? Have y'all seen that chicken that she posted?
Nah.
Had like all
the new chicken that they got?
Hey, man.
The live chicken?
Y'all ain't eating chicken.
Yeah, I know.
What is that? She said, look, I'm going to stop eating meat. I was like, yeah, I would advise you.
I saw that.
That looked gross. I wish there was a way she could post a picture of that on there.
Yeah, so it had something in the leg underneath the
skin. No, it looked like it was falling apart when she pulled it out.
Yeah, I saw that.
It was like,
wow.
Dissipate.
Beware of the fake chicken. We learned a long time ago to Big Mike.
That chicken that she bought?
Yeah.
Where did you buy that chicken from? There's not that many chickens in the world.
Right. Like KFC, they had to change the name from Kentucky Fried Chicken to KFC.
Yeah.
Y'all eating pigeon a lot of times.
Chemical fried.
Yeah, the pigeon is pretty good.
But a pigeon is like, not. It's in the same family as a chicken.
It's pretty good, but it's called. It should be cheaper than chicken. Yeah.
Kentucky Fried Chemicals.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But you know.
Hey, man, what's up, man? Why you walking so slow, man?
What's up, man?
Unbreakable's in the building.
Unbreakable.
Yeah, and Mike said chicken is a hybrid bird anyway. Absolutely. Yeah, man, you like. I mean, absolutely. That's why everything tastes like chicken.
Mark got some chickens.
Yeah,
I want to go help. I want to eat one of Mark's chickens.
Oh, here comes my wife. She said, don't stop eating meat. Just get properly sourced meat that's not in the grocery store.
Okay, Tracy.
It's okay to stay away from chicken, though.
So where, Tracy? Where you get it at?
You got to order. Sprouts? You got to order gotta online. Order? Yeah.
Damn.
Or you can do all that? Or you can go to the halal market or the Jewish butcher and get your meat.
Really?
But yeah. The King Super's chicken?
No, Tyson. No.
Don't do that.
Hey, that allegedly. Hey, man, don't be good. Don't be putting King Super's on blast.
Tiara said Sam's Club. What they got at Sam's Club?
That was the chicken.
Oh, okay.
That was where she got that chicken from.
Oh, okay.
Oh, really?
Sam's Club?
Yeah. Tracy, put the website on the way you get your meats from. The meats.
We have the meats. Anubis said there's a brother in Fort Collins who raises livestock.
Find you someone like that.
Yeah.
How much is it though? $100 a chicken? $100 for a 12 piece?
It's expensive for sure.
So y'all telling me Popeye's chicken ain't chicken?
No.
Oh, hell no.
I definitely wouldn't trust that. My wife said you can go to Western Daughters or to a local meat market.
Western Daughters?
Yep. They sell grass fed beef and.
Dude, that Popeye's breast is wonderful. That's like a really good piece of meat.
My sister told me with her mouth, she was like, I'd rather have the GMO chicken because it tastes better.
Wow. Well, she's honest.
So we might get sick. We might get sick if we eat some real chicken, huh?
I know my boy Hashim, not the one that's on this thread, but Hashim Malik Bey, he was traveling to Africa. He hit me up. He's like, bro, he's like, I'm convinced this is the best chicken I ever had in my life. He's like, I don't know what the hell we eating back in the States.
Right.
Really?
Well, I'm convinced, man. It don't matter what you eat in America.
It's poison.
They just want you to keep eating it. They just want you to be obedient.
Hey, you know what? They said that in text too. I thought about you.
You gonna crowbar that thing in anyway?
I thought about you, man. They said that in text on Sunday. You gotta trust.
That's right. Ain't nobody living that.
I said, uh-oh.
You gotta trust. So the brother in Fort Collins, he doesn't use any antibiotics, and it's all grass-fed.
Okay.
So if you want to get you, and I'm sure it's going to cost you too.
So I thought the antibiotics kill everything, all the bad stuff in the chicken.
No, the antibiotics is for them to, they keep their hand keeps their shelf life.
Yeah.
Oh.
And so.
Yeah.
Okay.
Keep them, you know what I'm saying, nice and fat and juicy.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, keep them growing.
And don't forget that the food coloring that they put in to make it look fresh.
They're doing that to vegetables too now.
They do that to salmon as well. They color the salmon, make it look pinker.
Yeah, they do it to vegetables too.
How they do that? What colors they put?
They do. Yeah. They do.
No, yeah. They don't. Show me.
Yes, they do.
They say a lot of vegetables is bad for you.
Bad.
Too.
Horrible.
Fruits and vegetables, though. So.
Yeah,
we'll just eat air.
So what can we eat?
Eat a peanut butter and jelly sandwich.
You know what? Tracy said Moink Box or Butcher Box. Those are good spots. Lucky in Colorado, there are a lot of grass-fed farms too. They say they sell to whole paycheck too. Oh, that's Whole Foods.
Whole paycheck.
Whole paycheck. You go to Whole Foods, man.
Man,
boy. So do you in your home, Herm? Do you and Tracy just buy the meat and just store it in the freezer, or do y'all? Uh-huh. Okay.
Yeah. Because you know it's I don't eat meat.
There we go, Mark.
My brother said, "Grow your own food."
I'm gonna come.
But then you gotta be careful if you grow your own food because the enemy controls the seeds.
Right.
It's Monsanto seeds, so you get the GMO seeds.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's best to
No way to win. The best way is fast.
Fasting.
Just eat
one meal a day.
Yeah, eat as little as you possibly can.
That's
why you have certain foods here in the States not even accepted in other countries. You
exactly.
Know? And they'll have the exact same product. Like a box of Cheerios got a whole different set of ingredients than, yep, than they do here in America.
Oh, really? A lot of those cereals, they won't even let you, they don't even sell them in other countries.
Right. It's, other countries don't even allow McDonald's to.
Right.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying?
They won't accept any American meat.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
What?
Too many preservatives.
They've been trying to kill us for a long time.
For a long time.
Yeah. American meat.
Well, I mean, this is the whole system that they feeds itself, right? So they give us the food, and by us eating it, we need health care, so we got to go to the hospital.
Right,
you
right.
know what I'm saying? It's perpetual. It just goes around in a circle.
And that's the other thing.
From
that,
the toothpaste to everything.
Did y'all hear about Costco's promoting the weight loss drug? You can get a prescription for Costco.
Really?
You what, hear that?
Ozempic?
Yeah.
Yeah,
you
huh.
didn't hear that this morning. Okay.
Man, I'm scared of Ozempic.
My wife said vegetables are the most reactive foods on the planet, meaning they cause most of the reactions like allergic and inflammation.
Tracy, we're going to have a conversation, just me and you, sis, okay?
Sayyid is mad about that, Tracy. Tell him, Tracy.
We're going to have a conversation. I know you're going to be ready, Tracy, and I'm going to be ready too, okay?
Nah, she's right. But
What you supposed to say, huh?
I'm just saying. I don't eat meat either.
You told me that.
But I'm just saying, she's right. That's what I'm saying. You gotta just fast. Like Mike said, fast and pray. Pray before you eat any of that crap. Cause we are in trouble.
Yeah. No, but I'll be the first to admit that there's a lot of GMO vegetables out there that mm-hmm. you really should not be consuming.
Right.
It's like a lot of people think that, you know, we know of a sister who had cancer and she thought she was doing her body a service by eating fruits.
Oh man, that was the worst thing she could do. You're talking about Opalanga.
Opalanga. Yeah. And she was eating nothing but GMO fruits. All that sugar content, and that enhanced the cancer.
Yeah.
So a lot of that fruit that they have in the market is not good for you. I'm actually
seedless.
I'm teasing, you know, when I do.
Yeah.
Know,
and to your point, fruit is not supposed to be, I mean, it's supposed to have colors, but not, they're not supposed to look like crayons,
like bright right. colors,
right?
You know what I mean?
Magic markers,
shiny, bright.
Right. That's no, all they
have.
Your fruits
have a little dough.
But they know that people eat with their eyes, and
exactly.
they
attract
the trying to go for it. You know?
This is fresh.
That's amazing too, because there's a science involved in colors. Like if you if you notice, if you go to all these different fast food restaurants, they all have the same colors.
There's red, yellow. Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Those are the colors that make you hungry. So yeah. McDonald's and yeah, Taco right. Bell. And
I read that.
Yeah. Kentucky Fried Chicken. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? They all have the same little color scheme.
Yeah.
And also with that, with the attracting piece that they have with the GMO on how addictive that food is.
Right.
And us being melanated people, how that pulls with the melanin, you know, that's why so many black people are so sick, because they can't stop eating that processed food.
Yeah. And Mrs. Charles, in terms of what you were talking about, B said, I told y'all Ozempic is the devil. Almost took me out. And, you know, they don't work on everybody either.
Right.
So-called, you know what I'm saying? For one, they're diabetic drugs, not weight loss drugs. But the side effect is weight loss, but it don't work on everybody.
Right.
Then if it does work on you, you got to keep taking it. You know what I'm saying? You got to keep injecting yourself, or else them LBs.
Are you gonna get fat again?
Yep.
Dang.
You're fat faster.
You get fatter.
Rotund.
But that's what we was talking about. How you said fast, which will help. And at the very beginning of Ramadan, when 6 point
yes.
something billion people are about to fast, they come out with this thing on saying that how fasting messes with your heart.
And did you know, my wife and I, we read that article and it had no scientific basis whatsoever.
Really?
Yep. But what they were counting on is that what people would just see the headline, like we do, mm-hmm. and go off the headline.
Right.
That's and just exactly. run with it.
And just go with it. Oh man, it's crazy, dude.
But then on the flip side, they got Oprah promoting
Ozempic.
Yeah.
Ozempics.
Yeah.
Yep. Is that, I say the right word?
Ozempic. Yeah. And that was strategic too, because what Oprah was trying to do was avoid a lawsuit.
Yeah.
So she's taking Ozempic or whatever weight loss drug she's taking.
But she's also a spokesman for
Weight Watchers.
Weight Watchers.
So if she loses weight and it's not because of Weight Watchers, then that's a lawsuit.
Oh.
You know what I'm saying? So she
had to do that.
Getting herself from underneath that. Preemptive.
Didn't she give up the Weight Watchers?
She gave up her position and as being a, because she had like a position on the board and being a spokesperson, of course. So Mike said, did you hear about the new device that they want to give everybody to monitor glucose levels? No, I haven't heard about that. And Tracy talked about that study, about that article.
Mm-hmm.
It said it was 20,000 people, but only 418 people were in the fasting group. So it was totally unscientific, man. Totally unscientific.
Well, we called BS as soon as we saw the thing, you know. But you're right. People will just read that article and be like, see?
And just roll with it, yep.
Y'all can't be doing that.
Mm-hmm. You're going to kill yourself. Not eating all day. You gotta eat 3 meals a day.
Square meals a day.
Five.
If you don't cut it out. Or 6 small meals. And a snack.
No, you wanna get your metabolism going. You gotta eat all day.
Right, you gotta eat all day. You're killing your fool self. So yeah, man, it's they're trying to kill us.
That's actually a documentary on Tubi called They're Trying to Kill Us.
Mm-hmm.
And it speaks of the food industry and black people.
Right.
Oh, you watch Tubi, huh? Motherfucker right here.
We should watch it.
Uh-huh. Tubi.
He busted.
Alana's in the building. Hey, Alana.
Lana Tevin.
Tevin's here. Hey, man, y'all. The whole Travis crew is up in here.
The whole Adams family is up in this.
Da, 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 da.
The creepy and the cookie.
Yeah, Mike, find that article, man, because I definitely like to read that. Yeah, man. True. They are trying to kill us, y'all. They're trying to kill us. What's going on with the Diddy? Anybody hear anything?
I was just about to ask. Did he do it?
He did it.
Did he done?
Did he do it, Diddy? He did it. He's man. Done. What's up with the Diddy?
I don't even want to.
Diddy don't.
Who his son? What his son do? Who his son assault?
Oh, they found some cocaine at the house. Oh, really?
Which one? The one that looked just like him?
Yeah. King?
King. Yeah.
Man. Diddy did something, man.
Diddy did
something to the higher ups. And we speculating. Maybe Jamie Foxx is behind it. Maybe Christopher Williams is behind it. Somebody behind it.
What if it's all made up?
Huh?
What if it's all made up?
What if it's all made up? What if something really coming down the pipe? What's the 52 fake out?
But you know,
tell me what's going on in legislation.
Because the whole Diddy thing kind of perplexes me. I'm really suspicious because you don't come the way that they come and you don't make an arrest.
Right, right.
One, they didn't arrest nobody.
Homeland Security, though.
Homeland Security. FBI. They come with their... You know what I'm saying? A little military
This is all just speculation, man. The internet is a monster because they really expanded this whole Diddy controversy to an enormous level, you know?
I seen something where they said Prince Harry was on one of them lists. And the Prince Harry news came out. As soon as the Prince Harry news came out, the bridge got hit, and Diddy got raided. You got to be bigger. Y'all set
Yolanda
it up.
Said,
Prince Harry.
Yolanda says she just thinks he's a small piece of the puzzle. But, like, what's the... I'm suspicious.
So you Do you feel he's innocent, or you think?
I don't think anybody in that industry is innocent. However, the way that they came, it just doesn't make sense. You know what I mean? Like, when you come like that, somebody going to jail. The whole matter of fact, a whole bunch of people going to jail, but nobody going to jail. Y'all just leave with evidence of what?
And it seemed like every day is something else,
right? And that, the internet is just taking it and running.
That audio didn't help either.
The audio of him and me.
See, and that could be like the audio. Like, what is that?
That been out.
What is that?
And they just resurfaced that.
But if that's their business, that don't help.
But you know how it is. Like, how black people will throw you under the bus. Like, what way can you get a black dude out? But you take a dude that been acting like he's straight and turn him gay.
Yeah.
In front of the black community, like a rapper. And now nobody will mess with Diddy. Yeah.
Right. But see, that's my whole thing. Like, there's no arrest, man.
I mean, how fast did they arrest R. Kelly when all the allegations was flying
Some
around?
Years.
It was years.
It took years.
You gotta wait on it. Yeah.
But when they came to get him, they came and got him. They didn't go get no evidence.
Did they raided his studio and home?
Yeah.
They came and without an arrest. Coming with us, pal.
But did they do that to him without an arrest at any point?
Yeah, he had to turn himself in.
Oh, he turned himself in. He didn't get arrested.
Mm. You know,
so maybe it's just the process when you get to the elite class of U.S. citizens, you know, who got paper, you know, that, you know.
I don't know. It's just weird.
Hey, look, man, if your president can have 92 felonies, fuck it, man. Do what you want to do, man.
Right.
Do what you want to do in life, man.
91 felonies.
Right.
Do what you want to do.
Nobody. You're obviously doing that.
Don't let nobody tell you that you can't be who you want to be.
Yolanda said Meek Mill said it wasn't him in his saggy voice.
Yeah, right.
I didn't get a recording. Hey,
all that screaming rapping you doing, that was you.
Them niggas sound like some demons in there. They sound like two demons up in there.
So he was disturbed.
I was like,
what is this?
What is this?
Like, we're playing Fortnite.
Stop.
I haven't heard it, man. I haven't heard it. I just keep hearing a bunch of rumors about this and that and the other, but it's like, he did all this. He need to be in jail. They didn't arrest him, like, and they got all that evidence. They raided both cribs, and he's still not under arrest.
What if it's fake?
What if it's fake?
What if something happened?
What if something happened? There's too many people having similar stories from different angles. You know.
See, that's what I'm saying. Like, we go from what were we talking about, Gaza and all that,
right?
To now nothing. Now right. Diddy.
Like, oh, this is the distraction. Let's talk about Gaza. Let's get off of Diddy for a minute. Did y'all hear that? The IDF, Israeli Defense Forces, killed. That's what I was asking on boy yesterday. They killed the aid workers.
Yes.
The people who came to bring
food.
We're
trying to give them aid. And now they're turning the ships around. Now Palestinians can't get
the aid. Now no food is coming. Man.
So that's what the Diddy cover-up is.
Got people, you know.
But how you, like, that's like the Red Cross coming and you just be like.
And then the Red Cross are like, hold up, listen, turn around.
They killed the aid workers, Trav.
Wow.
And someone was American too.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Were they American?
But now you have U.S. people are trying to low key go against Israel. They're not gonna flat out, you know, say. But
right.
their hands is already bloody right now.
Right.
You know.
That's what they don't want. They don't want that.
Yeah. Even though Joe.
What's Joe Biden doing? Sleep.
Right.
You already know. That dude got up this morning and got sleepy.
What happened?
Let me tell you something. Well, see, wait, here's the real deal.
Oh, that guy, when Godfrey imitated Joe Biden, like,
here's the real deal. Here's the deal. One.
See, because Americans, if you doing something and you kill some Americans, Americans want to fight.
Right.
But they're not going to fight their buddy.
Oh.
You see what I'm saying?
I'm curious to see how this go play out.
That's probably why the whole Diddy thing is covering up the whole world.
But now you have
every day is something Diddy.
You have U.S. government people who are quitting now because
right
they're not. They said that this morning on the Omar report.
And this is what's so crazy. They killed the Israeli Defense Forces. Killed the aid workers, and then they investigate themselves as to what really happened.
Right.
How you do that?
Listen, if I commit a crime, I want to investigate myself. You know what? I'm just going to investigate myself. Yeah. Go on.
I'll let you all know how the investigation turns out.
I'll let you know next year how it went. All right?
So that's like, your son killed somebody. Let me go see in there and see who would come back out.
Right.
It wasn't as bad as y'all thought.
Right. Like, it's crazy, man. Maybe
what was his take on it, though, that you had the conversation with? Did he know anything about that?
Yeah, he knew all about it. You know.
What did
he couldn't say nothing. He didn't have nothing. He's like, I know, man. It's like, they should have been trying to feed them Palestinians.
I don't like that dude.
That's like that. No, he really believes in what he said.
Yeah, he does. It's like
our boy. He watches that thing, so he believes everything that's been said.
Right.
So he's like Trumpy. Everything Trump says, he believes.
Right.
But he believes
everything. Oh, I was reading that news too. Donald Trump, because you know he had to pay $175 million bond.
How did he come up with the money?
He had a bondsman. And the bondsman, guess what the bondsman, what type of business he has?
What?
Subprime car loans.
Subprime. Really?
And this dude is a billionaire.
Really?
And he's the one who came up with Trump's bond.
So what he does is he gives cars to people he know can't afford them, and they goes and get them back.
And he's a billionaire.
Billionaire. That's the business.
He's a billionaire.
I wonder how many black folks he did that to. Now that they got that.
A billion worth.
But they gave him a car for 3 weeks.
He said that Trump backed it with cash, though. Who knows?
Yeah, okay.
But Trump, I just read something that he just lost $1 billion because of Truth Social isn't doing that good on the market.
Ooh.
It's not profitable at all.
I mean, he still got a home at X.
Yeah, but you know, he wants his own stuff. You know what I'm saying? He ain't messing with Elon.
X is X rated. I like X. I'm gonna give me an account on X. And just throw X.
Yolanda said, yeah, right. That clown is broke. No, they said, after Yolanda, they said Trump is worth $6.4
billion. 6.4?
Yeah.
So he could have paid his own bond.
He lost $1 billion on True Social. They said he lost $1 billion. He's still worth $6 billion. Trump got some money. Anytime you fly around on your own plane, I don't care what y'all talking about. Anthony said he's broke too. If you got a big old 737, you got some bread.
Yeah.
With your name on it.
Right.
Yeah.
Cause that ain't no one time thing. You gotta take care of that plane year round. Right.
You got a hotel in Vegas.
You got some money. And you got a staff that operates that plane too.
Exactly. Trump got some money. Y'all don't get it twisted. He's a blowhard, I hear you, but he got some bread. He got some bread.
Huh. Trump ain't broke.
Uh-uh. Yeah, he's definitely smart. He knows how to spend other people's money, too.
Right.
That's the name of the game.
That's the real name of the game, especially in this country.
Other people's money.
Yeah. You don't want to spend your own. I'm trying to figure out a way.
How to spend some other people's money.
Right.
For real. I haven't figured it out yet, though.
Man, Hancock, call us, man.
He's done, Trav. Like, he talking black now. He really don't have no power.
Cool. Black Mike?
Yeah, Black Mike. Black Mike.
Yeah, Black Mike ain't got nothing coming now. Nothing.
How's he talking black?
Y'all? He's supposed to get us a building, man.
I told you he was at the little awards thing, the little My Brother's Keeper thing. He was mad. He was coming with it. I was like,
who is this?
You said that? For real. He was talking about slavery.
He said that?
Yes. They took our names. I was like, what the hell? What's going on, Mike?
You should have rolled up on like, nigga, when you start talking like that?
When I got out of office. Real stuff, man.
That ain't how he talk. Real like stuff. That.
What y'all got to sell? Haircuts.
Haircuts.
Y'all can come get a haircut. I got some space today.
And we moving. The new gone. Place is gonna be cracking too.
We moving, y'all. Don't
we moving, that. Y'all. I'm gonna have that address up next week, God willing. But we gonna be here till at least the end of April. So, go to astar2.com and schedule your appointment. Don't walk up in here without one.
What is it, 8606?
The address to the new space is 8060 East Girard 8060. Avenue. The nearest cross streets are Hamden and Tamarack, the main arteries.
Right by Benihana's, y'all.
Right by Benihana's and Tarjay.
Cool. Right by Benny Hines.
Yeah.
So we're getting the remodel started, and we'll be there in the beginning of May. We're gonna have a big grand opening to welcome all y'all's, and it's gonna be fun. I'm excited. Change is good. Hey, Nichelle Tarver's in the building, y'all. She just joined in.
Nichelle, you just woke up.
You late, Michelle.
Michelle.
Where you been, Michelle?
What else we got? But anyway, yeah, go to that site, astar2.com, schedule your appointment, get some merch. Look out for the grand opening. What else y'all got?
I'm going to write a book with my cousin here. I'm going to write a book, a very interesting book. Yes. His life has been very interesting to me.
The Unbreakable, and let me come up with a title. Unbreakable and the Nasty Man.
No, you should call it Unbreakable Balls.
Hey. Woo.
Right on, Miss Antoinette. She said congratulations. Thank you. Yeah, we look forward to seeing all y'all. But we should we run up on it? Y'all don't have nothing to sell? Oh, I gotta say shout outs to the Nugs. The Nugs are with the number one.
Yeah, we're back to number one.
Back to number one.
We're hey, Tony lived out there where that bridge is, man. That bridge that collapsed.
What bridge?
Yep.
Oh.
I think Tony takes that bridge to work sometime.
Really?
Yep. I think I did see a post.
We didn't talk about that, huh? That bridge collapsing.
Yeah. Ooh. That looked fake. Okay. It looked like a like the World Trade Center.
Uh-oh. There was a little charges.
Yeah.
I don't know though.
Little implosion. Little nice little implosion.
Yeah.
I don't know.
I don't know.
I saw it, but I
look. It looked like little sparks.
Yeah,
you
know, I
see the sparks up top. Like, we're there when the metal hit metal, you're going to get a spark.
Yeah.
The Francis.
Nah, the way it popped, the way it broke.
Not just the Key Bridge, Miss Antoinette, but the Francis Scott Key Bridge. Y'all know who that is, right?
That's the Star Spangled Banner.
Uh huh. And you know what he was singing about?
We need a Francis Cress Wilson blues.
He was singing about the glorification of slavery, mm-hmm. keeping you niggas in chains. Mm. Right. And the bridge is gone. But uh-oh. That's all good. We getting up out of here, y'all.
Regina Grace.
Regina just walked
in. You trying to sneak up in here, Regina. No, no.
After that, said, we call it the key bridge here. Yeah. Yeah. Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. We getting out. Y'all don't have nothing else?
Nothing else.
All right. Well, we could get with y'all on the next one. Subscribe to the podcast. Remember, if you don't stand for something, you will fall for absolutely anything. We out, and we'll see y'all on the next one. Peace.
Right. Peace.
Say.
Speak how you walk, how you blink, how you talk, how you teach, how you reach. Let it sink. What's your purpose? What's your passion? Did it pay? What's your plan? Is it plain? On a plane? Hydroplane? I'm just playing. What's your purpose? What's your passion? Did it pay? What's your plan? Is it plain? On a plane? Hydroplane? I'm just playing.
Thanks for watching, you guys. We both love and appreciate you for doing so, but we need for you to take some action and do us one or two or maybe three more favors. And that is, go ahead and smash that like button, share it if you really dig the video, and also subscribe. That way you'll get a bell ding, a notification every time we post something, and it also helps us with regards to the algorithm that, you know, your people like to run. So go ahead and do that, and we'll see y'all on the next one. Peace.